All right.
How y'all feeling?
Good.
Y'all gonna have to talk back. Give me a little something. How's the day going for y'all?
Amazing. Good.
Okay. I'm excited about our workshop. My name is Nathan Jameson. I am speaker, professional consultant. I do a lot of leadership training. I work with colleges, elementary schools, middle schools, high schools, churches, all kinds of different organizations. They bring me in and I do a lot of development, right? For young people, for adults, sports teams, all kind of stuff. So I'm with you guys today and we are going to have, it's going to be really like a discussion, but you taking off?
Yeah. I'm probably going to be back. I just got to see my mom real quick.
Okay. It's going to be a discussion, but there's also going to be a lot of activities and stuff that I need you guys to do. I will warn you, we are going to talk about some pretty heavy stuff in here. I like for my sessions to be therapeutic. I like for us to be honest. I like to be real and authentic. And I believe the only way that you guys can really get the most out of the sessions is if I'm that way and if you guys give me that back. Can y'all do that?
Yes.
Can y'all do that?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Another thing, when I ask you guys questions, when I ask for engagement, I need you guys to give it back to me, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, what is this a picture of?
Hamburger.
Is it?
Yes.
Yes. If it's a hamburger with cheese, it's what?
Cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger. What is this in my name? Very quickly, give me a pillow. I have used it for that before. Very quickly, what I want you guys to do, one by one, you're gonna come to the front of the room. You're gonna grab this cheeseburger. Tell me your name and tell me just one thing interesting about yourself. Your name and one thing interesting about yourself. Anybody can start.
I don't know. What's interesting?
You have to come to the front though. I need you guys to come up front.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Isaiah, and I'm short.
Yeah.
Wayne. I'm Evan, and I like to cook for my family sometimes.
Cook what?
Like cook, like desserts or main dishes like spaghetti or like barbecue burgers.
Okay, cool. I need you guys. I need you on
there.
Yes, go.
Here.
No, she got me.
I'm Abigail, and I'm Nigerian.
All right. How old are, okay, so, and how old are you?
I'm 14.
14?
15.
16.
Okay.
I'm a somebody said.
No, don't do that. We still have 1, 2, 3, 4 people left.
Hi, I'm Yamani. I'm 17 and I like to play jazz.
Oh, sweet.
Okay. No! Take it!
You just give it to her. She's being shy.
Can we sit down and do it?
No.
It's okay. You got this. I believe in you.
You got it.
Clap
it
right here.
Huh?
I don't know
if it's worth it. Hey, do me a favor, y'all. Clap it up. You got this. Come on.
My name is
Amaya.
I don't know if it's
interesting.
My hair is brown.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
My name is Sophia, and I like to cook.
Cook what? What kind of food? Do you have any specialty
like,
dishes?
I like breakfast a lot.
Do you cook for your family or only yourself?
My family sometimes.
Okay. Nice.
My name is Leo. Yeah. Thing interesting about myself. I'm athletic and I'm African. So, yeah.
All right. Do me a favor, everybody. Clap up for yourselves for getting up there and sharing your little sentiments for telling me about yourself. Clap up for yourself. Clap up for yourself, people. That was just a little icebreaker activity, just for me to kind of get to know you guys, see who was comfortable with being up here. I like to do a lot of movement in my sessions. I like to do a lot of you know, have a lot of objects, a lot of things, a lot of visuals, props to get you guys to really understand the content of what we're going to talk about. Yeah, we're going to start off pretty light, but we're going to dive into maybe some stuff that may be heavy for a few of you. It may be freeing for a few of you. It may be therapeutic for a few of you. And so our presentation, our workshop today is called what? What does it say?
Family Matters.
What does it say?
Family Matters.
Are you all familiar with the show Family Matters?
Yep.
Some of y'all, because y'all, I mean, you guys are young.
Yeah.
Have you, you've at least seen the picture of these characters from the show?
Oh, yeah.
What about the Cosby Show?
Yep.
The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air?
Yep.
Will Smith, Uncle Phil. So you guys are familiar.
Mm-hmm.
So I named this workshop Family Matters for two reasons. One, because family does matter, and this workshop is focused on family, relationships, family dynamics, but also because there are family matters that we all deal with. There are matters that come from our family. There are situations that we may be born into. There are family dynamics that we're born into, things that we have to deal with as you guys get older, grow up, get further in school, get further education, and become young adults. I need you guys to give me, when you hear family, what's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear family? Anybody can yell it out. First thing that comes to your mind when you hear family?
The people that love you.
The people that love you, all right.
A group of people.
A group of people? People you live with? Anybody else? Family. First thing that comes to your mind when you hear family?
A group of people that have been together since birth.
Okay. All right. I just wanted to get you guys' perspective on it. This is like a literal definition that I just gathered off of the internet. A group of two or more persons related by birth, marriage, or adoption who live together. This small fine print down here says all families are different. But I want you guys to understand by the time we're done with our session, each of us come from somewhere. Each of us have families, but a lot of our family dynamics are going to be totally different. A lot of our experiences that we have within our families are going to be totally different, and they all shape how you guys are. They shape your behavior, the way you dress, the way you act, the way you think, because of those experiences. And so you guys have a choice. And that's ultimately what I want you guys to realize when we are done with this workshop, is that you guys have a choice. Whether or not to let some of those negative experiences that we have with our family stop us, hinder us, get in the way, or choose to do the opposite and allow it to be a motivating factor so that you guys can continue on the road to success. Y'all believe that? If you believe that, say cheeseburger.
Cheeseburger.
I need you to shout cheeseburger if you believe that.
Cheeseburger.
All right. The nuclear family, this is just a definition of the general nuclear family, like the regular, basic, general family. A couple and their children as related, as a basic social unit. A husband, a wife, children. Boyfriend, girlfriend, children, right? What does it say, Abigail? Can you read this for me, please?
It says, describe your family in foods, dishes, and explain why you chose those dishes.
All right, I need you to get back to the front of the room again. One by one, you're going to describe your family in food dishes and explain why you chose those dishes. You get to pick three, and you're going to explain them to Nate and to the rest of the room. Anybody can go. And if you can't pick three, you can maybe do two if you're more comfortable with two. Think about it.
So, my family's probably like...
And keep in mind, you don't have to pick any of those dishes on there.
My family's probably like pizza or burgers or probably just a like really good meatloaf with a side or something.
Why?
Because like all those, they have like at least like something that's like not usually there,
mm-hmm.
but can be added on there.
All right.
Because like my family has like is a little different.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I like that. Thank you, sir. Anaya? Come on, Anaya. I need somebody else to go. Somebody's got to go.
Can you have to get over there?
Yes. I make people get out of their comfort zone. So if you may not be as comfortable getting in front of people and speaking. Somebody else has to go. Who's next? Thank you.
Family's like turkey because turkey's at Thanksgiving and Thanksgiving when we get together a lot.
Okay. All right. Thank you. We have a few more people. So many different types of dishes.
My family's like a cheesecake cake. It's like a cake, but then the bottom layer is also a cheesecake. And I think it's because both of those things are very good, but when they go together, it tastes amazing.
Mm.
And so my family, like, there's two, like, my family are of two different cultures.
Mm-hmm.
And so, when both those cultures are great, but celebrating them together is awesome. So, yeah.
Okay, nice, nice. Anaya, let's go. Okay. Thank you. We have. Thank you.
What is that?
You said, what is it?
Yeah, what is that?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, I don't know.
Remember, it doesn't have to be any images on there.
Well, my family would, be a silent type, you know, because family relationship is really healthy in some way. Yeah.
Nice. Thank you. For my man that just walked in, what's your name?
Braylon.
Braylon. We're having everybody describe their family in a food dish. So you can pick one, you can pick three, it's your choice.
Basically, I would say maybe a salad because everybody else is very, like, different, but it mixes well.
Ooh.
So.
Yeah. I like that. I like that. And then lastly, we have Braylon. Friend in the room, please.
I'll pick a pizza.
You said pizza?
Yeah.
Why?
Everybody's different. They're all class. And one different. And one class at the same time. But certain parts are better than others. Like the crust and everything. That's
all right. Okay, I appreciate y'all. Clap up for yourselves again. Clap up for yourselves again, young people. Are you guys finding it difficult to get up here and speak and talk in front of the room?
No.
No?
Not really.
So you guys are comfortable with it? Y'all cool with it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
I think it's because there's not that many people. If there was like 30 people, then I feel like it would be more like 50 or
60. So you think if there was more people,
yeah,
people would be like more comfortable?
Because I had to like give a speech about my entire school once, like, everybody in our entire grade had to. And it was very different.
Sheesh, that's a lot. That's a lot. For a high schooler, that's a lot. Wow. I don't even think, but I was your age, that I was... I did have to do like a senior speech, but whatever. Okay, so I really want to focus on you guys' families, and I'm hoping that you guys can open up during our session, because like I mentioned before, we're going to dive into kind of some deep stuff. So I want... Braylon, can you read these six different family structures for the people?
Nuclear family, single parent family.
Oh, and define them. So read what nuclear family is and make sure you're speaking to them.
Nuclear family consists of husband and wife along with children. Single parent family consists of a single parent raising one or more children. Extended family consists of two or more people, either related by blood or marriage. Child's family consists of couples who don't have children. Grandparent family consists of grandparents raising children while parents stay busy. Step family consists of new husband or wife and children from their previous relationship.
Thank you, sir. You each have a yellow or just a colored piece of paper on your table. You can pick whatever color you want. You're going to grab a pen. Identify which one of these is your family structure, or whatever is most similar to your family structure. Is it one, the nuclear family, which consists of a husband, a wife, along with children? Single parent family, where a single parent raising one or more children. Three, extended family, where it consists of two or more people, either related by blood or marriage. Childless family, well, you all have children, so. Grandparent family, grandparents are raising children while the parents are busy. Or the step family, where you have like a new husband or a new wife, and children from previous relationships, blended families. I'll give you guys a few minutes. Everybody done? Are we good? No, you don't have to put your names on it. Are we good? Okay, so we each come from these families, right? I've been your age. I've been in a lot of y'all's shoes. I've been through a lot of the same experiences as some of you. Maybe some of you haven't been through some of the experiences, but we all come from family. We were birthed somewhere. We came from somebody. We were brought into, we didn't just magically get here by the snap of a finger. Someone brought us into this world, so we were attached to someone by blood. Would y'all agree? So, what tends to happen, and I want you guys to listen to this, what tends to happen as you guys get older, you guys begin to go through more experiences. You guys may have traumatic events happen to you. You guys may experience hardship with your families. You guys may go through some stuff that is good. You may have great moments with your family. You may lose a mom. You may lose a dad. You may see abuse in the home. You may be the one receiving abuse inside of your home. Maybe you had to move a lot throughout your childhood because there was instability. Maybe you never had to move because there was stability in the household. Maybe it was financial issues. Maybe your parents filed bankruptcy. All of these are different scenarios. All of these are different experiences that if I talked to everyone who was in that auditorium earlier could probably relate to in one way or another. Does that make sense? Now the problem with families, sometimes we don't come from the best situations. Some of us come from situations that are healthy. Some of us come from situations that are unhealthy. What does this D word right here say?
Dysfunctional.
And then we have healthy. I'm going to ask some more volunteers to come read what it looks like to be in a healthy family dynamic. Anybody? Go ahead. And then who wants to read the unhealthy? B? Because before we can talk about this stuff, because we're going to do some more activities, but before we can talk about it and do those activities, we need to identify, learn, and really get into the meat of what healthy looks like, what unhealthy looks like. Because here's the deal, and I need you guys to listen to me. I'm not that old, but I'm not that young. I've lived a little bit longer than y'all, and here's one thing I do know. If you come from something unhealthy, if you come from toxicity, if you come from things that were dysfunctional, if we don't resolve it, if we don't identify it, talk about it, you can fall into that same cycle when you start your own family. We want to prevent that. Do y'all agree?
Yeah.
Would y'all agree? All right, go ahead.
Communication is key to building up a strong, unshaken bond in a healthy family. There is an understanding level. Healthy families accept each other. They have zero tolerance for physical abuse and toxic behavior. In a healthy family, rebuilding a damaged relationship is a top-notch priority. In a healthy family, every member gets involved, works, and plays together.
Thank you. And who's going to read my dysfunctional? Thank you. And it's going to be a little bit longer. I think it's like 18 different lines. So those are just some traits of healthy. Now we're looking at some traits of dysfunction.
18 signs of a dysfunctional family. They are verbally or physically abusive. They make you feel that you are never, that you can never do or say anything right. They gaslight you. Lack of empathy. They play victim to circumstances. They create. You feel uncomfortable when they're around. They put you down more than they lift you up. They use personal information against you. They try to control you. They are judgmental. You feel like you are walking on eggshells, so as you don't upset them, they have anger issues.
Thank you so much. By a show of hands, do any of those 18, or I don't even know if that was 18, do any of those 12 apply to anyone in this room? Have you ever experienced any of those? Without going into detail. Okay. Myself as well. What I want you guys to do is stand up. Am I up in front of the room? And I'm going to show you guys something that I know to be true. Excuse me. So you guys are going to line up here. I'm going to be right here. So we can start the line here, meaning you'll be next after me. What I want you guys to do, you're going to pick up this bag.
Oh.
You're going to put it over your shoulder. And I want you to try to walk with it. Okay? So you're going to pick it up. Try to walk with it. Walk down here. Walk over here. Just walk back and forth. One by one. So who wants to go first? Alright. Just go back and forth about six times. Try to sling it over you if it'll fit.
What you put in there?
And then whenever you're done, next person can go up, you can pick up the bag, and you'll try to walk with it a few times as well.
That was about six times, right?
All the way down.
Right. You should try it too.
You
got it?
You want to go first? Huh? You want to go first?
How's it feeling?
Heavy.
Is it?
Yes.
Very.
You got this.
It's kind of light. I'm going to light.
Kind of light.
He can pick it up.
You got it.
It didn't look quite when you took it off.
Who's next?
Me.
your cheesecake.
Braylon, let's get it. How old are you, Braylon?
14.
Hmm.
14.
There's gonna be some real mess of twist at the end of this, isn't there?
Yeah, reveal what it is.
How's it feel?
It's gonna be fun to yourself.
It's like when my mom asked me to come get the groceries.
He said it's like my mom asked you to come get the groceries?
Yeah, I just grab one.
What's it called again? Masterpieces?
Alright, our next volunteer participant. Thank you, sir. Who's next? Who's stepping into the gauntlet? You don't want to go?
Got it.
Go. Abigail.
It's...
Never mind. Just, y'all can handle it. Yeah, you got it. Just go back and forth out. Who's next? Is it?
Yeah.
I have two more people.
15 minutes. It was 15 minutes like 5 minutes ago, so maybe like 10. I'll try to solve the rest. Right. So I'll come and get you when it's time, but about 10 minutes.
Okay. Come on. I need my two people. My next two. By a show of hands, once again, how many of you have experienced something on that list? So we have this list of certain things that happen in maybe family dynamics that are dysfunctional, right? Verbally or physically abusive, gaslighting, lack of empathy, trying to control you, putting you down more than they lift you up. You feel uncomfortable when they're around. If anything on that list has applied to you, raise your hand. Ever. Okay. I did this demonstration because I want you guys to realize something. Somebody scroll up on that screen for me, please. And I'm going to ask you guys a question. What are you carrying? And I had you guys walk back and forth with this duffel bag because one thing I do know, I may not be that old, but like I told you before, I'm not that young. One thing I do know is that you can carry around problems, toxic traits, trauma, bad behavior, things that were heavy from your family with you as you move throughout life. And you guys were walking back and forth with this bag. But the thing is, okay, the first five times may have been okay. But if I would have said, y'all need to do 25, you need to move with this thing 25, you would have started to wear down. You would have started to get tired. You would have started to feel it. And so what I'm ultimately saying, and what I'm ultimately asking you guys is, what are you carrying? If you're carrying anything, but if not, be aware that there's a possibility that you could in the future, if we come from family situations that may not be the most healthiest, or have experienced things that are not that healthy. You're walking, you're carrying. It may be cool initially. You may think, okay, cool, I can just switch arms, I'll be all right. I can just switch position on the back, I'll be okay. But over time, it will wear you down. If I ask you guys to walk with this bag for 1 mile, do you think y'all could have done it without being like,
no.
By the end of that mile?
No.
Like, I couldn't have done it.
You think you could have done it?
Yeah.
You guys think you could have done it?
No.
My question is, what are you guys carrying around? And here's the deal. Check out my slide for me, please. Just because your family packed it, doesn't mean you have to carry it around. Now, this doesn't mean that we all come from negative family dynamics, have been through a lot of things in our families that were not positive. Some of us may come from extremely positive households and have had a lot of great experiences. But some of us may not. Some of us have came from situations, like the board says, where you have things packed away in your life that are not the most healthy. So guys, I need you guys to do a quick activity for me. Because here's the deal. We've went over, and I wish we would have had more time, but I'm kind of trying to cram in a lot in a short amount of time. We went over family dynamics, healthy, positive. I had you guys identify different family structures that you have in your own households. Next, what I want you guys to do is to write a letter to your family. I want you to write a letter to your family. I'm going to give you guys about probably the remainder of the time to do so. And this letter can be formatted however you want it to be. But I want you to just write an open letter to your family. Dear family, whatever you want to put. However, you can have the freedom to create how you want to create. This is to your family. This is to your family. Remember, I told you guys, family matters had two meanings. The first meaning, that family actually does matter. The second meaning is the matters of the family, things that your family goes through that you have to deal with as well. And so I don't want any of you to ever get in the mindset of thinking that we don't need family. However, there are some things that you may need to change or unpack or get up off of you that came from your family. That makes sense, Abigail? Your open letter to your family. Open letter to your family.
Yeah. And right there, right above it.
Oh. Open letter. It's an open letter. You have the freedom to create. I don't want you guys to worry about being offensive. I don't want you guys to worry about cuss words. I don't want you guys to worry about writing the wrong thing. This is your time to write freely. Turn your paper over and line up. Is that right in front of the mirror?
Paper out.
Leave it with me, or you can take it if you don't want me to read it, but I was going to read them. And then line up directly in front of the mirror. And after you line up in front of the mirror, you'll exit out, and I believe you guys are heading to lunch. Remember, you can leave your papers with me, or you can take them with you.
When should I directly have to this class, too?
Brandon, you all right? All right, line up, line up, line up. Ooh, you're crazy. You guys line up. First thing you're going to do is you're going to tell your family one thing, and then you're going to tell yourself something about your future. So tell your family one thing, tell yourself something else about your future. Tell your family one thing and tell yourself something about your future. Are we ready? Go ahead.
For everything, and I can't wait to go my own way. You felt that one coming.
Do me one more favor, clap it up for yourself. You guys may be dismissed. You can go on. I believe you're going to lunch. Good job. I think you're. Hold on. You said, do you go?